It's no secret that SmartSuite is one of the fastest evolving tools inside of the no-code space. And in this particular video, I want to break down for you a lot of the new features and enhancements that they've made over the first quarter of 2024. So if that's of interest to you, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth, and this is Gap Consulting, where we help you unlock the full potential of your no-code tools. SmartSuite is one of our favorite no-code tools on this channel. We love it both for the database components, but also their automations and amazing permissions that they give the users. In this video, as I mentioned, we're going to be breaking down all of the new features, the new releases that they've made in Q1 of 2024. Now, a little bit of housekeeping. This recording is happening on March 15th, so it's not technically the end of the quarter yet, but we're pretty darn close. So there might be some new things that come out in the next couple of weeks that are even bigger. In fact, I might know of one or two of them, and we'll be doing videos specifically for those upcoming features. But for now, we're going to be focusing on the announcements that have already happened in Q1. Now, beyond that, you might also be curious about no-code in general. If you're new to this channel, I strongly recommend that you first check out our automation training. I've got that set up for you at gapconsulting.io/webinar-registration. There you can go ahead and sign up for that training that is completely free, and it's going to walk through for you how to think of building automation in no code. This is going to allow you to reclaim your time, and it doesn't matter what tool you're using, automation works the same across all different platforms. So that being said, let's go ahead and now jump on into the heart of the video. And I want to just start with what you see here on my screen, which is the what's new. So the idea here is that SmartSuite is becoming smarter and better at letting us know about all the changes. And I'm excited because when I log into SmartSuite, this just popped up and I was like, perfect. So number one, this is a big one, honestly. This came back in January. You've got the record cover image. So right here, you can see that when we're opening up a record, we can get the cover image to show up here in what is essentially the title almost of the record. So if you have an attachment field inside of your record, you can then make it part of that cover image. And so in the example here, you see they're using a property, and this is kind of perfect, right? If you're talking about properties or real estate, you obviously want to be able to get a visual indication of what that is. And so this is taking that attachment field type right inside of the record, and it's basically making it part of the title in that sense, right? Assigning that cover image so that it is the first thing that you see when you access that data. Very, very helpful, because as we know, no code is about helping people to evolve past a spreadsheet, right? It's so much more than just rows and columns, and I love this feature. Now, moving on to the next one here, we've got the record section description. So inside of SmartSuite, when we open up our records, we're able to see the different sections that we create. So we have a lot of control over how the data is displayed. Now, the record section description allows you to put together a little bit of a description, as it would imply, for each section. So let's imagine that in one record, you're creating maybe contacts. So the records that you're storing here are all going to be filled with contact information. So maybe you want to bring in a lot of different contact information like emails and phone numbers, etc., and you have multiple different fields for this. So if you were storing, let's say, personal contact information, and then you were storing work information, you could create different sections for this inside of the record, and you could sort and put different data where it belongs. And now you can, thanks to the record section description, give a little blurb in terms of what those different sections are. Now, the next one here, this is a big one. It's showing and hiding tables. So why is this important? Well, you might already know that SmartSuite is best in class when it comes to permissions for the data that you're sharing. Inside of SmartSuite, they have, bar none, the best permissions in the no-code space. And so the little blurb here is saying that you can now hide tables that you don't access regularly or that you think you might not want general users to see. So in order to visualize them or get access, simply click on the table dropdown and hide it, and then access it the same way. So there we go. We can now hide tables. So they're still there working in the background. This is particularly important if you are using a lot of junction tables. So a junction table is a more complicated way of structuring your data. We've done many videos on this in the past, which I encourage you to check out. But the important takeaway for you is sometimes you don't need to see all of that information, and it's kind of cluttering up your bar, your toolbar. And so if you want to hide that, you can. It's still there. It's still working. You can still access it, but it's now not prominently viewed right up front. Moving on, we now have the dependency subfield accessibility. So when we are putting this all together, we have dependencies with predecessors and successors, and this new option, this new feature, is allowing us to take the predecessor and successor information and display it independently in grid, allowing you to edit and interact with them in the same way that you would a linked record. So if you're using a lot of dependencies, you are going to absolutely love this new feature. And this was just announced a couple days ago as of this recording. All right, so moving on here, we have automations. So we can now find enhancements. So the find action has been upgraded, and this is native to SmartSuite's automations inside of their own platform. And so this new function inside of the find feature of SmartSuite actions allows us to toggle on either a single record or multiple records. So this is really helpful in the case where, let's say you know that you're going to search only one record. Well, then when you return that record after you find it, you will very likely want to do something after that, right? So if you return a single record, you can then use its value in the subsequent actions. So if you find a record and you know you're only looking for one, you can now do things with it in the future. And this is really kind of taking SmartSuite's automations to the next level and helping us do more within the no-code automation space. Now, alternatively, you can find a list of multiple records as well, simply by toggling on that little switch right there. So thank you for the enhancements to the record finding action inside of automations. Moving on, we have the automations to merge records action. So this was a really highly requested thing by a lot of the consultants inside of the SmartSuite space, and I'm excited to see how people start using this. So imagine, if you will, that you are collecting information through forms or some sort of data scrubbing, and very often you find that you have duplicate things inside of your tables. Again, if we use the idea of contacts, maybe you have similar different email addresses or names, you know, multiple contacts being added, but it's all the same person, the same individual. Well, now we can use automation to automatically merge those records. How cool is that? I've never even heard of this before SmartSuite brought it to our attention a few weeks ago. So, in late January 2024, they released this function. So now inside of your SmartSuite automation, you can merge records. Very cool. Now, still on the automation train, we now can clear, append, and replace. So this is pretty neat. You know, I'll dive into the text here. It says field updates in automations have been enhanced to support the update action type, which now allows you to append, replace, or clear existing values from fields. It's easier than ever to handle any record update scenario. So yes, if you are updating records through automation inside of SmartSuite, we can now clear, append, and replace information inside of those records. Now moving on, we have descriptions. So we can view the descriptions, and here it's saying you have the option to include descriptions for your views. So a view is simply a specific way that you might want to look at data. Different view types like calendars and timelines and Kanbans and all of that. But you can also choose what data is showing up on that view. And so now within our views, we can add descriptions that tell people the different things that are available inside of that view and why they might choose to use that view. Moving on from here, we also have enhancements to make integrations. And as I may have alluded to at the beginning of this video, I may have an insider scoop on some upcoming enhancements. I can't let the cat out of the bag yet, but it may or may not revolve around here, at least in part. So yes, SmartSuite is improving their integrations with Make. I highly recommend that if you're using SmartSuite and Make in tandem, that you are diving into this, because there are some really cool enhancements that have already been announced and perhaps more on the way that are going to allow you to do even more within your SmartSuite integrations. Now, we also have some updates for the formula functions on related records. As you see here, formulas have been enhanced with functions to sort those related records and return their value in a list. So imagine if you have multiple links from one record to another, and you want to, with a formula, look up all of the different linked records. You can do that now even better with your new functionality in formulas. Very, very cool stuff. A little bit advanced, but very powerful as well. And then lastly, we have some updates for time tracking log fields in formulas, also very, very powerful. Now, I know we went fast through all of these features and we didn't really dive into any examples. So if there are particular features that you love here that you want to see, let me know in the chat so that I can include new videos about them. That's it for this one. In the meantime, my friend, keep on building.